Remember what you said when the lockdown began? Now that I have all the time in the world, I will do all the things that I'm passionate about. I will focus on my health. I will work on my big idea. I'll even start my blog. It's more than 6 months now. Where are you today? According to the data published by Nielsen and BARC, the internet usage soared up, especially in the Indian cities, by 54% only in the month of May. Which means every second individual in the cities are using internet, especially for chatting, social networking, video streaming and gaming. This video is not to tell you about the internet usage. It's about what we told ourselves we would do during the lockdown. The moot question is, why don't we do what we know we should? Why do we end up aimlessly surfing on the social media platform? Why isn't it easy to stop things we know are bad for us? And hey, it's August already. Where are you with regard to your New Year resolutions? The answers, according to the authors of The Immunity to Change, can be found behind our habitual behaviors and mindsets. Instead of writing them off as bad, we should look at what good purpose is it serving. In short, it means, what am I secretly more committed to? The reason we are unable to do what we want to do is because what we are currently doing is giving us pleasure. There's a kick in dopamine every time you're browsing through your phone or watching Netflix. That is why you find it difficult to put it down or shut it off. That's the reason why we get addicted. So habitually, we are more committed to this pleasure. The pleasure is in the comfort of the couch, while any activity that makes you move out of it for a longer period of time is uncomfortable. Way back in 2017, I spoke to you about how you can successfully create habits in 3 steps based on Charles Duhigg's book, The Power of Habits. Here's a quick look at those steps. There is a science behind the process of habit formation. Charles Duhigg, in his book, The Power of Habit, explains a simple neurological loop at the core of every habit. He calls it a habit loop, a simple framework with 3 steps. Step number 1, cues. Cues are triggers that serve us as a reminder to initiate your behavior every single day. When you start a new habit, it's easy to say that I am motivated and I can do it. But this is exactly why most of us fail. We often rely on our memory, and it's quite possible in the busyness of life, we forget to do it. Therefore, triggers become critical in forming new habits. You're not just relying on your memory, nor are you relying on the motivation that you get. And the best way to start a trigger is to base it on your existing habit. For example, if your goal is to meditate, what can be the best trigger that can come out of your existing habit? Can the morning alarm serve you as a reminder? Or would you prefer to meditate right after the bath? In which case, taking a bath will become your trigger. Step number 2 is routine. Routine is the action that you take. It is the habit that you're trying to form. So when you're starting a habit, make sure that you choose the easiest one to start. Leo Babuta says, make it so easy that you cannot say no. Staying with our example of meditation, your routine would be sitting down in your meditation spot, cutting out all the distractions and closing your eyes. In the beginning, it doesn't matter whether your mind wanders and you're unable to concentrate. Focus more on the fact that you're sitting down every single day at a designated time. You will automatically improve your performance, or in this case, concentration, as you form the habit. Step number 3 is to focus on the reward. Reward is focusing on the benefit that you will gain out of this habit. So it is important that you understand what is the reason why you wanted to start this habit in the first place. If someone asks you to do it and you don't think it's important, there are 100% chances that you will not do it. But if forming this habit is important to you, then create a reward system for every achieved routine, and it need not be tangible all the time. Staying with our example, you can create a task of meditate for 10 minutes in your to-do list. And every time you check it off, your brain creates dopamine, which is a neurotransmitter in our body that connects you with pleasure and motivation. This will make you feel good about yourself, and you're likely to do this task over and over again because of this feel-good factor. You need to go through the entire video to understand the premise which Charles has laid in these 3 steps. I will provide a link to that in the description below. To conclude, I'd like to say we are what our habits are. If you're happy with where you are and what you're doing, then you're sorted. There's absolutely no need. But if you're not, if you want to grow or change any particular behavior, then you may want to change your habits around it. If you need help in overcoming though, you may reach out to me. All my details are there on the screen and in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, do hit a like button and share it with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and follow my page on Facebook. I'll see you next week. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.